Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. I hope all of you are well. I know what some of you are thinking. Finally, he has come back from the bloody moon. I haven't been at the moon. There hasn't been many videos recently because there's been a lot of real life stuff getting in the way. Everything's okay. I promise you, everything's okay. This channel is going nowhere, but you have to prioritize. You've got to prioritize real life because this is purely a hobby. But here is another video based on the moon, and you can fly me to the moon as we play Moon Patrol on the Amiga. So, if you haven't subscribed, please click on the button and the bell. It costs you absolutely nothing, but it really helps this channel grow in more ways than one. This is a free channel, by the way. It's not monetized or anything like that. So as I say, every bit of growth you can give us really, really helps. But this is Moon Patrol loaded in on the MiSTer FPGA, recreating the Amiga. I'm going to be pushing one on the keyboard right now to start. And it is loading the game in. This is an incredible conversion. You can get it from the URL in the video description below. You can get it from the URL in the ticker. Probably the video description below is going to be a little bit easy if I remember to put it in. And this is loading. And there you go. That's Moon Patrol that you recognize. It looks so freaking awesome on the Amiga. And it sounds brilliant. It looks just like the arcade one. So we're going to put a coin in. Here we go. Coin goes in. Let's push the coin in. And it wants us to play one player. Off we go. And the sound is absolutely brilliant. It's fantastic. All right, here we go. So on the Amiga, the way they've done this is you've basically got jump and fire, and they're mapped to different buttons. So, you know, got to get used to an Amiga game with two buttons. You know, I've always found that a little bit uncanny because, you know, the Amiga never originally supported two buttons. So yeah, it takes a little bit of getting used to it for me, but we're going to try and get to the end of this. There might be some differences in this game, in this particular version, that we've got from what you might be familiar with in the arcade, because I don't know how accurate a conversion is, but it feels very, very good at the moment, I have to say. You know, my dingleberries are pulsating with excitement at this. It looks good. It feels good. It feels good. And we have to get to basically these checkpoints. So we're heading to checkpoint E at the moment as we go from A to Z. And I think, if I recall, you have to do it in 80 seconds. I can't quite remember. There's certainly quite an aggressive time limit. Oh, busy, busy, busy with bombs in the sky. Okay, come on, let's get you. All right, these ones are buggers. These ones are buggers because they create new landscapes for you with the bombs that blow. Oh, I fell in the hole. The bombs that blow the holes in the landscape. They're a bit of pain in the neck. And I somehow missed that one twice. Right, jump. There we go. There we go, there we go. Right, can we get to point E? Can we get to point E? Jump there. And there we go. We got to point E. Lovely. Ah, 85 seconds. Was it 80? Ah, damn. All right, no bonus for us, but it doesn't matter. And you can see who created this game in the ticker below. That's on a different screen, but it's right at the bottom now. Do go to that itch.io page and take a look at this bollocks, I died again. Do take a look at this glorious game. This is good. This is very good. It seems to play a little bit different, or it could be me. Maybe it's because the screen size is a little bit wider. I'm not as fluid at this as I used to be. We're going to have another go. We're going to start from the beginning. I want to try and get under 80, but I'm not as fluid at this as I am on the arcade machine. And I've done well when we've played the arcade versions before. It might be because of that. I think there's a slight resolution change on the screen, but, you know, but the thing is, it feels perfect. It feels absolutely perfect, but, or maybe I'm just not as good as I used to be on it. Who knows? That is a possibility. We've played this a few times. We've played this on the PK8, we've played it on the MiSTer FPGA, we might have even played it on main, we might have even done it on the Starcade challenges as well, you know, so it's a game that I am familiar with. But one thing that I haven't noticed as, and it, somewhere on the arcade version, there's a double rock, there's two little rocks that are very close together, and I thought they were on this first stretch, and I don't recall seeing them on the first stretch. That's not a problem, by the way, you know, quite frankly, the less rocks you have, the better. But they on the arcade machine, there is definitely a double rock, which is two little rocks that are right next to each other. Now maybe we'll see them later, you know, maybe. And by the way, they are not little Dwayne Johnsons as well, let's just get that out there. They are rocks. So I'm going as fast as I can. Oh no, I jumped to that friggin hole. I was going as fast as I can, and then I wrecked it. You know, I want to try and get below 80. Alright, okay, in a minute we got these guys here. Don't like those guys. They give me new problems, but we're traveling at quite a speed, so we should be alright. Right, how do we... Oh, 79. Yes, we got below 80 just by 100, and that includes a loss of life. This is a really, really good conversion. There you go. 1,000 points. We have broken a record. Yes. You don't often see that at the Gentleman's Pixel Club. All right. Okay. Those buggers are out of the way now. Yeah, I'm expecting to see two little rocks next to each other. Maybe it's on this bit. Who knows? Who knows? Right, got everything there. Come on, H. Focus, focus, focus. I was struggling at that point just then because I was trying to figure out what missile was going to put a hole in the ground, because these blue guys up above, when they do their missiles, you get new landscape, and I was trying to avoid that. Oh no! Maybe that's the double rock there. Alright, we didn't do too well there. Right, okay. New landscape coming up. Oh, it was all fingers and thumbs. I got the buttons wrong. Okay, we need to have another go at this. We have absolutely got to have another go at this. So we're going to let the timer tick down because I want to start from the beginning. Let's see whether we can get better than 79 of your gentleman's seconds. All right, so one player to start again. Moon Patrol, off we go on the Amiga. God, can you imagine? Can you imagine if this had come out as it is now, as what you see now on the Amiga, when the Amiga was having games released? You know, the magazines would have literally shit bricks with enthusiasm. It would have been the cover art on every single magazine that you had there. You know, this is phenomenal. This really, really is. You know, it's so amazing what coders, what people do these days on these retro systems. You know, what they give us, what they create, the changes that we have. It's absolutely phenomenal. It really, really is. By the way, when you boot this up, you know, there are different versions. Come on, jump. There are different versions of this. So different Migas will play versions with like different things, if what I read is correctly. So for instance, these mountains may not be present on all versions. It's just how it is, because this is obviously, not obviously, but we're playing on what is an Amiga A1200 on the MiSTer FPGA. So yeah, you know, different versions have different things based on the capabilities of their machine. Okay, I think we've got one more set of these blue guys in the air as well. Oh no, we haven't. 72 seconds. Oh, we're getting better. All right, time to reach point E. Go on, this is going to be a healthy bonus. Ah, well, not that healthy, but you know what, it does. Right, okay, let's keep going. Let's not try and wreck this for all these bad guys we've got above us. Oh, I pushed the jump button at the wrong time, and when I landed, I had to push it again. The timing was all off. The timing was broken. Oh, mother hen. I was doing so well, and then it's all gone to poop. If you want to see me play this well, there is a video of me playing Moon Patrol, the arcade version, where I do extremely well on a single credit. Alright, okay, let's get these rocks. Jump. Rocks. Oh, and they got me. They got me. Holy hell. That's it. We didn't do so well. You know, we're going to have one more game on this when this counter ticks all the way down from the beginning. I say this is a lovely, lovely conversion. You know, I can play so much better than what we're playing at the moment. Maybe there's some, it's because there's some slight differences, and it could even be down to muscle memory and what the resolution is. Who knows? I'm not finding it brutally hard, but I am nowhere near as good as this as I can be. And you know, there's no real reason that I can see why. You know, I'm just going to have to try and be better. You know, maybe we can get our 72 seconds down a little bit more. Ha! No, we can't. Not at that rate. Alright. Sometimes you can do a little jump when the missile is close to you just to survive it. Right. And if you survive it, it changes your position quite drastically and quickly, because sometimes it will miss, other times it will allow you to shoot it. But yeah, no, you saw me do a little jump there a bit earlier on, just after I mentioned that, and that helped me get through the challenge a little bit easier there. We lost a life, and we did it in 68. That's pretty damn good. Holy hell. Okay. I would like to get above 10,000 points. Okay, there was nothing I could do there. I was being spit roasted by missiles from multiple directions. Oh yes, nearly there, nearly there. Yes, 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 we've done it, we've done it, we have got the points I wanted to get. Okay, 78 seconds, did we do what we needed to do? 78 average time, 80, yes, we got another record. Okay, we're doing all right. I ain't gonna get much further. You know, my skills are a bit off at this for the moment, but you know, at least you're getting some reasonable gameplay from me for once on the most incredible arcade conversion. Okay, we basically got to jump these vines. Oh, that was a finger and a thumb button. That was a finger and a thumb button where I screwed up. Gotta say, this will go down. This is one of the greatest arcade conversions you can see on the Amiga. This is friggin' incredible. If you enjoy Amiga games, if you enjoy Moon Patrol, go and take a look at this yourself. You will not be disappointed. All of you stay safe. All of you take care. And I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.
Retro gaming at a feeling fine. Now like and subscribe if you would to the Gentleman's Pixel Club. Pixel Club, retro gaming is so much fun. Pixel Club. just for gentlemen. The Gentleman's Pixel Club. The Gentleman's Pixel Club. Now like and subscribe if you